In today's video, I'll show you the simplest way to set up Android Studio and the NDK to create C++ applications for Android. Android Studio is a development environment used to build Android apps. While it mainly supports Java and Kotlin, Android Studio also lets you write C and C++ code using the native development kit, NDK, which we will be using. The first step is to download Android Studio. Head over to developer.android.com and click on the Download Android Studio button. Once the download completes, open the installer to start the setup. The installation process is straightforward. Just follow the prompts. When you reach the end, click Finish to launch Android Studio. The first time you open Android Studio, you will be prompted to choose a setup type. For simplicity, select Standard and click Next. You will then see a screen to review your settings. If everything looks good, press Next again. Next, Android Studio will ask you to accept the license agreement for the additional components it's about to download. Check Accept and click Finish. Android Studio will now begin downloading essential components like the Android SDK and the necessary libraries to help you get started with development. Now, occasionally, Android Studio may appear to be stuck on the screen for a while. In my case, it took over 20 minutes to begin downloading the necessary components. If this happens, don't close the installer, be patient and give it time. It should eventually start on its own. This is a known issue that has persisted for some time, so don't worry if it seems unresponsive at first. Just let it run and it will work. The download process can take quite a while, depending on your internet speed, as the total download size exceeds 1 GB. Now that the installation of the additional components is complete, we can create our first Android app to ensure everything is functioning correctly before proceeding with the installation of the NDK. From the welcome screen, we press this button to create a new project. From the templates, we select to create an empty activity project and we press Next. We give our application a name. I name it My First App. And for the build configuration language, I choose Groovy because I am more familiar with it, and then I press the Finish button. That's it. Our first Android Studio project is being created. The project is now importing. This step may take a few moments as Android Studio is configuring the necessary files and settings for our new project. During this process, it may also need to download additional files and dependencies, so don't be alarmed if it takes a little longer. In my case, it took more than 10 minutes for this procedure to complete. After that, we are ready to run our program for the first time. It is a simple Kotlin app that prints the message "Hello Android" on the screen. All we need to do is to click on the Run button, which is located right here. This action will initiate the build process, compiling our code and preparing the application for launch. At the same time, an emulator will open, providing a virtual Android environment to test our app. Once the build process is complete, our application will automatically run on the emulator. Keep in mind that if this is your first time loading the emulator, it may take a little while to start up. So, be patient as it loads. Just a few seconds later, our Android app is up and running on the emulator. How cool is that? Now that we can build Android apps using Kotlin, let's go ahead and install the NDK. So we can also develop apps using C or C++. Navigate to the menu and select Tools SDK Manager. A new window will appear. In the SDK Tools tab, we need to install two essential packages, NDK, Side-by-Side, and CMake. These tools will enable us to effectively build and manage our C++ projects within Android Studio. Next, we click Apply and Android Studio will begin downloading and installing these packages after we accept the license agreement. Once the installation is complete, we will be ready to create our own C++ projects or open a project from another developer. This setup will provide us with the necessary tools to develop powerful applications using native code on the Android platform. Let's open Raymob, an Android project that utilizes Raylib, a C graphics library. This project will serve as an excellent example of how to leverage C, C++ for graphics programming in Android development. To get started, we need to visit the GitHub repository of the project and download it. Once the download is complete, we will unzip the file. I will unzip it to my desktop. After unzipping, let's rename the folder to something more descriptive. I will name it Ball Example. Now let's open the project with Android Studio. In the dialog box that appears, we need to click on the Open Project button. Next, we will navigate to the desktop and select the Ball Example project folder. Now that our project is open, we are ready to start working on it. If Android Studio and the NDK are configured correctly, the project will begin syncing. This process may take some time, as Android Studio needs to download and configure all the necessary dependencies in the background. In this case, it will re-download the Android NDK, because this project is using a different version than the one we installed earlier. It is important to note that you can have multiple versions of the NDK installed side by side. This allows you to switch between versions as needed for different projects, ensuring compatibility with the specific requirements for each application. Once the sync process is finished, we should be all set to run the project. We click the Run button, and as you can see, our first C Android app is running on the emulator. Watch this video for more information on how to run your own Raylib C, C++ projects on Android. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe to my channel for more awesome programming tutorials. See you in the next video.